You see it all the time. People going to thrift stores and finding insane valuables for a fraction of the price. Don't believe me? Well, this dude found a literal golden egg at a thrift store and sold it for $33 million. Except when I go, I never find anything. So today I'm searching 100 thrift stores to see if I can turn a profit and become filthy rich. And so I wasted no time and started thrifting. After searching through some junk, I finally found an interesting item.
Look at this. Whoa, this is actually old.
And so I looked it up on eBay, which is the whole strategy I'll be using. I learned through some professionals online that you can look up an item on eBay and see what it last sold for.
Boron tennis racket, have no idea what this is. One sold yesterday for $150. Which means we're rich, basically. I think we could sell it on eBay for at least $100, which means we can make about $90 on this. We have 99 more stores to go, so let's get going.
The next few thrift stores were pretty weak.
Hey, there's no filming in the store, bro.
But eventually, we came up on our next items.
Golf Master. If that's not expensive, I don't know what is. I see a lot of these on eBay going for $24.99. I found another Wilson club, so I'm picking that up. I looked up this golf club. That means we have three golf clubs. That could be pretty good for our total.
At the end of the video, I'm gonna list all the items on eBay and see how much we can actually make. Let's just say Mr. Bezos might have some competition. Anything's possible.
Dr. Phil mug, we all know him, we all love him. Good old Dr. Phil. We could probably make like $14 on this, so we're gonna get it. I'm getting quicker, I'm getting more efficient. I know where to go when I enter the stores now. It's clockwork. Speaking of clocks, that looks nice. It's going for $6, and on eBay, it looks like it goes for around $50. So we're getting this for sure.
And then we kept on searching and searching and searching, but we weren't finding anything. And to be honest, I started to realize how hard this was actually gonna be.
I'm feeling so bad right now. I never find anything at thrift stores to begin with, but this is putting it into a new perspective. Either I'm cursed or the people that are finding stuff on the internet are the luckiest people alive. All I'm gonna do is keep thrifting. Let's go.
I just kept remembering that one quote from Jake the Dog, because he always said, sucking at something is the first step towards being sort of good at something. So we kept searching, and lo and behold, we came across an item.
So I just found three 22 karat hand-painted plates. They go for like $15 a piece. I'm gonna grab these. I found this Tigger mug. It's only $1.99, and it's going for $16 on eBay. So basically what's happening is, did that scare you?
Sorry.
I think we might have found something. This right here is a lacrosse helmet. They're selling it for $8. I went on eBay and they're selling for upwards of $100. I think we could make some really good profit on this. It's literally dark outside. We're gonna stay on the grind till 9 o'clock p.m. That's when they all close. You know the drill. Let's go.
We absolutely attacked the next thrift stores with the intention of profit. Store after store, we were finding nothing, but like always, we finally came across an absolute gem.
I came across this Supreme hat right here. It's $5. And I looked it up and they sell for like $50. People love this company, Supreme. Okay, we're buying this. All right, boys. I gotta take this hat off, dude. Found this Lego chicken plush toy. It's going for upwards of $30 on eBay. You can't go wrong with that, dude. Here's the plan. We're gonna hit as many thrift stores as we can till 9 p.m. All right, so we're gonna get to the car now, right now.
Where are we? I don't even know it's anywhere.
As the night came to an end and more thrift stores were closing, we powered through as many as possible, but we weren't finding anything, which leads me to
the last Goodwill of the night. I'm so exhausted. Let's end off the night right.
I searched this thrift store like no tomorrow, but ended up finding
literally nothing.
Bruh.
We're gonna leave now. Ugh. We searched 50 thrift stores, which was our goal, and we hit it barely. Tomorrow is gonna be crazy, and I'll tell you why. I found this thing on the internet that basically tells you where the highest income areas are, because I've heard that the best thrift stores are in the richest areas. So tomorrow we're gonna go to the richest areas, and if that's true, we might just come out on top tomorrow.
Let's go thrifting.
And so we embarked on a 2-hour drive to Los Angeles. I'm seriously convinced that everybody that lives here is rich, and honestly, I want a part of it. But if somehow that doesn't work, I do have one secret weapon. but we'll get to that later.
First thrift store of the day, we're in a place called Beverly Hills in Los Angeles. It's a really wealthy area, so these thrift stores are supposed to have some crazy stuff in them, so we're gonna find out.
I immediately realized that the stores in this area were a whole lot bigger, and it also seemed like the selection of items was a lot better. So hopefully we can find some pretty big items that'll help us add up to that big total at the end of the video.
We got these gray Adidas shoes. They're only $10, but I looked them up on eBay. So it looks like they go for around $50. So I think we can make some decent profit on these. This is a Wizard of Oz glasses set. They're only $7.99. They're going for like $30. We're getting them 100%. All right.
After those last couple items, I was feeling pretty good. That is until we hit a little something I like to call the dry spell of a lifetime. We hit an ungodly amount of stores without finding a single item.
Actually, so bad, dude.
It's really times like these where I push myself mentally. I honestly think you'd be surprised how hard it is to search 100 thrift stores. But we were already so far in that there was no going back. And eventually, after way too long, we finally found something.
These are actually really good. These right here are Adidas Forum shoes, they're called. These are only $10 and they sell on eBay for $80. I'll take anything I can get at this point. I'm getting these. I found this mug here. It goes for $15 on eBay. It's only $2.99, so I'm buying this and we're gonna profit off this. Hopefully. Hopefully is the big word here. Lakers hat, just found it. It's only $6, but it's $25 on eBay. That's a lot of money right there. That's a lot of profit. I'm gonna get this.
All right, so we kept searching and the next stores were just pure agony. I'm calling this my delusional phase.
I'm delusional. Don't mind us over here. All right.
We hit another massive dry streak, which wasn't helping, and the night was quickly coming to an end. Luckily, I still have my secret weapon. As I searched the last stores of the night, I struck gold.
This has banger potential right here. Ogre mug from the classic film Shrek. If you don't like Shrek, I don't like you. I'm gonna look this guy up. This is our best item.
What? What?
Sold less than a week ago for $53.
For a mug.
And the one before it sold for $65. They're selling it for $2. We actually just struck gold on the last store. What are the odds of that? The timing, bro. It's my favorite one too, on top of it.
Yeah, I literally love this mug, and it seemed like everybody else did too.
Oh, that's pretty,
that is pretty
cool.
Thing's,
oh, nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm proud of it, so. You're probably wondering, what about the 100th? That's the secret weapon. I can't tell you, though. Let's go. Okay, we just arrived. It's time for the secret weapon. This is our last chance to make as much profit as we possibly can. It's a little place called the Goodwill Bins.
And let me just say, this place is no joke. It's basically a super discounted thrift store where the items are sold by the pound. Only true thrift professionals go here. I'm talking full-time resellers. You know, the types of guys that wear outfits like this. There's also a long list of rules you have to follow, including no fighting, no aggressive behavior, and no pushing. These people are not messing around, because you should see what people are finding here. And if this is all true, we might just end up rich.
Here we go. I'm nervous. I've heard a lot of scary things about this place, so...
So I walk in there and immediately the vibe is just stressful. Everybody is lined up on both sides of the building and apparently new bins are brought out every 20 minutes. So I got in line with the rest of the people and started waiting. I was getting looks from every direction and I felt extremely uncomfortable. After waiting for about 5 minutes, it was time. But first, I want to tell you guys, thank you. I really am super proud of what we've built on this channel. Each and every one of you guys is helping me achieve my dreams to become a YouTuber. And if you guys didn't know, we have a goal of reaching 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. We only have like a month left, so if you guys would consider subscribing, it would really mean the world. But seriously, I need you guys to see these bins because it's crazy. People were running and pushing. I felt like I was in a battle royale game. I was desperately trying to keep up with everybody and search for things.
This is so stressful.
But I'll be honest, I was struggling. I was also pretty bummed out because at this point I invested so much time that I didn't want to fail.
Dude, I'm not finding anything.
After searching relentlessly for hours, I started to kind of just let go and look for things that I just thought were cool. Honestly, once I was able to let go of the whole money thing, I started having the most fun I've had this entire video, and all I was doing was getting things I liked. I mean, check out this Minecraft sword I found. Now, if that isn't a good life lesson, I don't know what is. So, it's been a week since we last listed the items. I think going into this, I didn't realize how hard it was gonna be to search 100 thrift stores. I haven't even looked at the eBay account to see if the items sold. So, now, I guess it's time to look at the eBay account and see how much money we made. 3, 2, 1. All that and we made $0.
Bruh.
All right, we're never doing that again. That's it. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting.